improvising all their lines.
From the thinnest of outlines!
In the style of 16th century Italian Commedia dell'Arte!
So we invite you to side with the lovers. Agitate with the thinkers. Hiss the evildoers. And laugh at the very, very helpful servants.
And also in the city of Venice is Dr. Graziano and his son, Lelio.
And today, their old friend from university, Signor Tifano, comes with his daughter Flaminia to cash in on an agreement made long ago. And now, we present to you the power of Venice!
It is perfectly clear.
Yes, of course, Father. You're so knowledgeable.
I will leave it to you.
Heathens. Stuffy, no good English.
Have some ill repute.
More heathens.
Have some healthy repute.
Slightly ill, but getting over cold repute. Oh, there's the river. Okay. So, that's the sun. So, east is that way.
Petrolino. Yes, Petrolino.
There are the dragons.
This. It's a beautiful day.
It is a beautiful
city. It is a beautiful city, it is a beautiful country, and it is filled with beautiful women.
You could have spent all your money on women again. I never get anything. No food, look at these.
My money, I am not spending my money on women. I am spending my father's money on women.
That makes it
sad. Yeah, it does. It's a lot easier.
Remember, the evils of love will take over your soul.
Oh.
And all your money. Yes.
All my money.
Evils of love.
Well, all right, what do I do?
You employ your best friend's, Lilio's, power of negative thinking.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Lilio.
If a woman is curvaceous,
she's fat.
No, she's curvaceous.
If she's thin, what do you got to hold on to?
All of her.
It's not much. If she's generous, she gives all your money away, and then what do you have left?
Charity is a virtue.
If she hoards it, she's cold and calculating.
She's safe.
Cold and...
Well, all right.
So, is this an opportunity? Yeah, this is an opportunity.
Yeah, all right.
Negative thinking. The power of negative thinking.
What do you got?
Too tall.
No.
She's too thin.
She's perfect height for. I don't even have to bend over to
kiss her. Here's the one that'll get you. Okay? You ready?
Right.
She doesn't like kit.
What did you just say about my mistress? She loves kittens. She is just as adorable as a kitten.
What?
So she and kittens have a lot in common, which is more than I can say for kittens and your master, because he's much too tall,
unlike you, who are the perfect height and eyes without any whimpering in the neck.
And your master's much too hairy, unlike you, whose hair is in the perfect shape and length. And his eyes are beady, unlike yours, are rather penetrating and entrancing. And what was I saying again? Oh, my! You were insulting my mistress, and I won't have none of it.
We can argue about this later. In the meanwhile, we have appointments to get.
Your arguments are very convincing, and I will enjoy arguing with you again at a later time.
In the mud, and it will get caked in your toes. get your heart broken. You will cry yourself to sleep, and you will fall asleep on a pillow that is wet with your own tears.
Oh, Aunt Victoria, you are so wise. I will emulate you in all ways.
Oh, no.
Well done, darling. Now, we will begin your lessons by practicing looking stainful in the mirror.
Alabino.
Yeah.
Alabino.
Yeah.
This is going to end well.
Yes.
For we are the new watch of the beautiful city of Venus. That means we have come here to watch for thieves.
Thieves!
Watch for kidnappers.
Kidnappers!
And watch for the beautiful women.
Women? Oh. Why women?
Because they're beautiful women. But we need to watch especially for one. For we have come to this town in particular. We have joined the watch so that we can find my long lost love. But Alakino?
Yeah?
This cannot go the same way it went last time.
You mean like in Rome?
No.
Paris?
No.
Alexandria?
No.
Constantinople?
No.
Istanbul?
Talk about that. What happens at Cooper's Lake stays at Cooper's Lake. Alakino.
Yeah.
This will be different.
Okay.
And the city of Venus will be ours. We will rid the city of crime. They will sing songs of us. There will be glory, especially of me. Because now that Capitano's Pavento has arrived, you may bask in my splendor!
Petrolino, I can't believe that! There she was, the most gorgeous woman in the city!
But I tried to save you.
Yeah, save me. Thanks a lot. Well, now I have to go and apologize for things that I didn't even say. Things that you said, but since you're my man, I have to apologize to her. I have to go and knock on her door and see her face to face. Petrolino, you're a genius! That was fantastic! Ah, save me. Yeah, you did, all right. All right, so.
Halt! Name of the watch!
What?
You! I've committed a crime!
A crime?
A crime!
No. I've done nothing of the sort. I was simply going to knock on the door there.
That's not a crime, but...
No.
But
see, there you go. And then I was going to apologize for the rude behavior of my servant.
That's also not a crime, but...
All right. And then I was going to ask the woman of the house to marry me.
That is a crime! For some reason! Because the woman in this house is my long-lost love.
Oh, no. The woman in this house is my love, and I just found her.
That's impossible.
Oh, no, I have her favor with me.
You're a thief! You stole that favor!
She gave it to me fair and square.
You stole it from her. That's the only way possible, because the woman in this house is my love.
You, sir, accuse me of being a thief?
I accuse you of being a thief.
All right, I challenge you to a duel. A duel. With the swords, like that one. The one right there next to you.
This one?
Yeah. I have one, and you have one, and we both endeavor to stick it in the other person.
Oh. Well, if that's the way you like it.
All right.
Bask in my splendor!
I know, I am
will not forfeit this. Capitano, what are your times?
My turn?
Yes.
What do you mean?
Well, will we duel to first touch, to first blood, to a counted number of blows? How would you like to do it?
This man is an Italian. He's probably a coward. I will scare him off. I challenge you to a duel to the death.
Oh. Yes! Capitano! You are a man after my own heart, not that way. Capitano, what better way to die? What better way to die than for love? For love of God or country or a woman? There is nothing better. There is no more glorious way to pass from this life to the next than with the name of your love on your lips. Capitano, you honor me with the opportunity to part this earth in the most glorious fashion possible. In fact, if you win, I will thank you. And if you lose, I will thank you. Well, we'll see you soon. Oh, no.
But
do you have a second?
Oh! No! I do not have a second, so we can't duel.
I love seconds! Oh, you have a second?
Thank you, Alucino.
You're welcome, Capitano.
You'd be a great second. I'd pick you in a heartbeat, except look at this man. He has no doublet, he has no sword, he has no nothing.
Oh, well, doublets can be borrowed, swords can be borrowed.
I'll go get them!
All right. Well, then, you have a second.
But you don't, and that would be unfair. So I guess we forfeit.
Petrolino!
That's me!
Old friend.
Yes, my
faithful
master.
Faithful servant.
Yes.
Come, help me.
Help me with the situation
I have. I have entered into a duel agreement with the Capitano here, and I need a second. And I am asking you to serve in that most honorable position.
It is a great honor, Master. I am deeply honored.
What?
I'm allergic to violence.
You can remember that line.
I know what to do. Arlecchino.
Yeah.
Go and find Lilio.
Lilio.
Tell him I need him as a second.
What?
He will do it. He is a very learned fellow. He has read all the fencing manuals. He knows his way around the league. So he will back second, and we will have the duel very soon. We'll meet back here. Capitano, it will be glorious. Ah, thank you. Thank you. Let's go, Petrolino.
Yeah, let's.
Alucino.
Yeah.
So, you're gonna go do these tasks, right?
Uh-huh.
Just like all the other times you've done tasks for me, right?
No, Capitano. This time I'll do it right.
This is not what you're supposed to be basking in!
Scappino! You villain! How many times have I told you? You must not steal from me, El Dottore. It is impossible. My son Lilio is so smart. He told me that he was out in the marketplace and he found my autographed copy of Plato's Stars Through the Ages. How can you do this to me? Oh, I am beside myself. I must practice my relaxation exercises.
Thank you so much, Master. I did so well covering my tracks this time.
Scappino, you are a rogue. You did not count on my brilliance. You were 4 minutes and 36 seconds late from your usual errands last Thursday. And the mud on your boots was of a color and consistency that matched that outside the booksellers. And, most telling of all, you have been more than usually happy as of late.
Yes, I must keep remembering not to act like you died.
Scapino, my father's sight is blurred, his mind is distracted, but mine, I have the eyes of a hawk, I have the courage of a lion, I have the moral rectitude of a priest. You can't get anything past me.
But I must be on my way, for two of my university friends from old times are back in town. We're meeting at Patalone's house, and I must be off.
Vittore, right?
Yes, that is me.
Good, I came to the right place. Ooh, first I went to Patalone's, then I went to this weird guy's. Glad to be here. Got a message.
Message?
Something about seconds.
Seconds.
And then I need to double it.
Double, you want extra portions.
Yeah,
I don't have any.
Melio, who is a guy who's helping Flavio!
Flavio, flavors of food.
No. Listen. Lelio is gonna skewer me.
I'm not sure if that's legal in Texas.
Because Pedrolino is allergic, and I need to take his seconds.
I have allergy potions.
Enough of this! Clearly, Flavio and Capitano have entered into a duel. Arlecchino is Capitano's second, and Flavio wishes for me to be his.
Yes, it's right!
Get your hands off me!
I couldn't fight this side!
Oh, woo! Duels often end in death, and death is very permanent.
Wait, you can die? I think you should duel 100%. I am right behind you now.
Yeah. I've been working on it.
Father, please. Do not worry yourself. Flavio, no doubt, is in this duel in a matter of love. He's always chasing one woman or another. He has not my powers of negative thinking. To be honest, I pity the boy.
Well, you take care of that like you always do. I must be off to Pantalones.
I shall meet Flavio and convince him to cancel the duel.
For his own good.
And there goes my master acting, just as pretentious as always. Just because I tried to make a coin or two so I can feed myself while they're off reading books.
Oh, even though Isabella and I have just returned, she has me shopping for all these heavy, heavy books. I mean, who needs a book about the anus? Or curing Rumpudius? Or Vegetus? Oh, that one sounds dirty. Ah, I am so glad to lighten that load. Take a load off.
You got a nice load there, huh?
Why, I don't recognize you. Who are you? And thank you for filling my basket.
I'll fill your basket any day. my name.
Yes, hello, your name.
My name. My name is Scapino.
Well, Scapino, welcome to the Pantalone household. I'm so glad to have you here. I've just returned from shopping for Isabella, and I have this very heavy load of books.
Really, you're complaining about shopping? I just got thrown around for trying to sell something so I could feed myself.
Well, I not only have one master, Isabella, but Pantalone, he orders me around and has me do totally disgusting things.
My master's father makes me use him as a footrest for when he reads.
Well, Pantalone, he likes to take a bath naked, and he has me rub his old wrinkly back with a sponge. Ew. Oh, yes.
Oh, we make our candles out of Vittori's earwax.
Cut his toenails. with my teeth.
Oh! Ew.
It is disgusting! All I want is my freedom! But I can't be free until Isabella is wed!
Does Isabella not want to marry?
No! She is against marriage. She's always walking around with her nose in one of these heavy books.
You want your freedom too, as do I.
You want your freedom too?
Of course. I don't want to be a servant my whole life.
Neither do I. We have something in common.
Besides loving heavy loads.
That's a little creepy.
Yeah.
Maybe we can have our masters get married. They're just as presumptuous. They're just as intellectual. They're just as rude.
That sounds like the best plan I've ever heard! Scampino!
Yeah, no, I'm not done yet. Oh. Yeah, no.
Oh, Scampino! Scampino!
Yeah, that's right, I'm okay with that.
I know Pantalone is an important business meeting, but Scampino, what you have to say is far more important. I will grab Pantalone right away.
Tell us more about this
time.
I call this meeting of the Fraternal Order of the Golden Ducket to order. I'll have the chicken.
I'll have the fish.
Get me a sangria.
So our plans, they are progressing quite well. Our children have grown up, and as we planned, my son Lilio will marry your daughter Isabella.
Yes. And my daughter Flaminia will be marrying your son Flavio.
Yes. Together, we'll be able to make our dreams come true and fulfill our ducket.
I shall go and buy the island of Lesbos in the former library there with lots of lady librarians.
All my plans are to get a few more magistrates in my pocket and to hire a few young, healthy, beautiful interns to handle my legal briefs.
I will own the island of Sicily, where I can have beautiful maidens service me treats and rub my feet on the beach.
working with you, gentlemen, it's like old times.
Yes, working together is like old.
Yes. Remember that fellow Ponzi that we...
Oh, how could I forget?
Yes.
He was always coming to that house I owned with all those beautiful working ladies.
And I would sell him those illegal potions that kept him stiff.
And put his household together while he was busy, as I recall.
But unfortunately, all of the elixirs did seem to weaken his heart until one day he passed away. The ladies say they had never seen a smile on such a man's face.
They made him stiff as a board. But you had his
estate was put into very good hands. Mine.
Oh, what old times those.
Miss Nelly, I have a message for you.
Spirits!
Speak.
The penalties will be... Blackmail!
We didn't even tell you what to do! How fast!
Creative. one thing we do not know yet. Kitten. We have no evidence that she likes kittens. Isabella, tell me, what sort of horrid person does not hold adoration in their heart for kittens?
So you are speaking of Felis domesticus, the type of household pet that can commonly cause irritation within the chest and irritation in the eyes, that they have created an alchemical formula to cure this in many people. But unfortunately, there is no alchemical formula that can cure me of the decrease in mental acuity that is caused by this plebeian conversation that we are having right now. So if you would excuse me.
Unspeakable! We're being blackmailed!
I've fallen in love.
Lelio, you don't fall in love. And it must be something else. It must be something else. He must be sick. Let me examine.
Then I was I tried to do the negative thing. But then she was just so smart. She was so, and she called me plebeian. What does that word even mean?
If he vanquishes you, then you die also
for the glory of my love for this beautiful woman in this house.
But if you were to disable or kill me...
Yes, well then, Petrolino steps in your place, and then he and I will fight, and with luck, he will kill me.
And what if, you know, with all the swords going back and forth, and my sword plunges into you, and your sword plunges into me at the same time?
Right, yeah.
What does he do then?
Well, then, Petrolino would take both our swords. And he would do his very best to stab himself first with each one. And thus honor would be satisfied, and each of us would have a glorious, glorious ending for true love. What more can a person ask?
Life!
Check the balance on it. Here, try this.
I want to live.
No, Petrolino. You are a servant. You have no good reason to live. To die in for your master's love. Glory, man, it's glorious.
I have a love of my own. A true love.
What, Petrolino? I had no idea.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Now, even better, you understand.
Yes.
The willingness to die for love.
For true love, I would even pinch someone.
I should remember that line too during this duel.
My true love lives right here in this house.
This house?
This house right here.
Aw, that's it. Wait, this house?
Yes.
The house of his love?
Your love?
My love. Petrolino, you've gone behind my back.
Oh.
I see your you said you've arranged this with her servant. Oh, you bastard.
Petrolino?
Faithless servant.
This is not what we meant by being our second. Wait! As the captain of the watch, I have a suggestion.
Right.
Your servant has wronged you, and
yes.
Obviously wronged you first because he's your servant and got here first. So how about the two of you do?
No thanks. No.
Go ahead, kill each other right now.
No. You and I should duel first.
Yeah.
See if we can actually kill each other first, and then he will have to commit suicide.
How about you commit suicide right now?
And you lay it. Oh, here. Lay it up against your neck. Please.
Yes, Paula, save me!
I'm coming, my beloved.
What? Who is this brother?
Thank you.
Colonel Sutton, that's not legal to do in public, but I can handle a law later.
Wait, when did Carnival come so early?
My beloved, let us go where it's a little more private.
You're right, let us go where no one can watch.
My love, let us go where it's a little more private.
All right. What is your name?
Something that we definitely won't have any arguments about.
Well, I think our plans actually came to fruition. Yes. They're all gonna marry each other just like we planned.
It obviously happened just the way we planned.
Yes. I love it when a good plan comes together.
Yes, it's true. And I'll be able to live our dreams and follow our ducking.
Yes. Well, let us go.
Father! Yes. She's so
funny. Oh, no. I can't hear this. I'm sorry. She's beautiful. The black
one. What do we do?
We're going to have to cancel the marriage. Oh,
no! You can't send her away! I'm in love with Benedetta!
Serena!
No! Remember the book's tragedy, heartache, love is bad!
I
hired the gypsies so they would blackmail you into getting Isabella to marry Lilio.
Oh, you put us through all that torture for nothing. I should have him meet you, and then I'll get to meet you.
No! Stop! No more fighting! Anyone can see that Lilio and Isabella are the perfect match! What kind of group of educated men would believe a bunch of gypsies? Anyone can see Lilio and Isabella need to get married!
Quick, they're thinking!
To freedom!
Now, wait a second here.
Yes.
Is your son actually smart?
Oh, yes, he is actually very intelligent. He has come down with a rather acute case of love. I am trying to cure him, but the potion's taking a while.
Well, maybe not all stories need to end in heartache. Maybe we can write our own. And you did manage the ablative form.
Perhaps one or two of your criticisms had some validity.
Or more.
My father has a library in his study. Books wall to wall. Thick, leather-bound tomes.
Do you think maybe we could go there and I could put one in my lap and make him on a finger in a thick volume?
But our plans did come through in the end. They are marrying each other.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
And you get to follow your dreams.
Are my dreams of Lesbos with all those young female librarians?
A collection of magistrates, I need to begin.
Yes, I get to make a pretty decadent punch, aren't you, on the whole deal?
Yes. So, let us be off.
Yes.
What do you need? You sound like you are in distress.
I did
All right. Out of here.
Yeah.
How do you feel about politics?
I hate bugs.
East Kingdom.